In particular, I'd like to focus in on the arts, the crafts and the cultural sectors and what supports are going to be there for those. I welcome the confirmation from Ms. Licken of the €20 million that's been allocated to the Arts Council as requested by the National Campaign for Arts. That's welcome news. And that recommendations have been already achieved. And could you expand further on what is being done in that sphere, please? Then, Mr. Falvey, I just have a question in relation to the actions from the National Campaign for Arts. In your statement, you suggested that the officials were analysing the reports from the Arts Council Expert Advisory Group on the National Campaign for the Arts, and that some recommendations have already been achieved. I'd like you just to elaborate, please, further on that, if you wouldn't mind, please.
I suppose on the question of the NCFA and the Expert Advisory Group from the Arts Council and their recommendations, a key recommendation was the €20 million funding, and we were in a position to provide that immediately, so that has been a really important immediate response. And just to take you through some of what the Arts Council has been doing for arts and arts organisations, the funding and the new funding will be aimed at A, the organisations and venues that support artists, so to keep them to a sustainable future for them, bursaries, commissioning and digital online content. And that's just a snapshot, but Conor can elaborate further on it. And in terms of production and performance, obviously we're very critically aware that the idea of performance and performance spaces is particularly challenging with social distancing. So it's not just a matter of you can reopen, it's can you reopen safely. And we've had a lot of engagement over the last 2 or 3 months with all of the sector on all of the challenges that face them, and setting up a task force, as is outlined in the programme for government, to deal with the whole of the culture sector will be a key part of helping to address those issues that are arising. I don't know, Conor, if you want to elaborate.
Yeah, I suppose traditionally we would have had our primary relationship would have been with the subsidised arts sector through the Arts Council Screen Ireland. I suppose given that there's a pandemic now, we have opened our doors to all callers essentially, and more recently we have been engaged with commercial venue operators and promoters, and they have issues around the roadmap and how they address it and supports that they consider necessary. So we received correspondence from them very recently, and that's under examination at present. In relation to the National Campaign for the Arts, we meet regularly with the National Campaign for the Arts. And again, they have fed in through the expert advisory process through the Arts Council, and there's a strong overlap between the recommendations that have emerged between the work of the expert advisory group and also the work of the National Campaign for the Arts. Some of these things are political issues, the appointment of the full ministers for culture. Some of them are requests for capital supports for venues, and that's being examined as a matter of urgency, and I would anticipate we'll have a proposal for the minister extremely shortly in relation to that. Other issues relate to the European Union, and the European Union has published a draft multi-annual financial framework commencing in 2021, which is subject to agreement at the European Council. There are sums of money set aside within that for SMEs. And the minister, previous minister, I beg your pardon, had looked in the context of previous council meetings for some of that funding to be ring-fenced for arts and culture. So we will continue to examine any opportunities that might present in relation to securing funding for Irish artists and cultural entities through those channels. So we will be continuing to engage with the National Campaign for the Arts and the Arts Council on all of these issues in the weeks and months ahead, both on a bilateral basis and through the task force structure.